Congested December. We've got Brentford away on just 2 days rest after this Leeds game. West Ham at home, Southampton and Manchester United. Spurs in the quarterfinal of the Carabao Cup. Crystal Palace away, and then on 2 days rest, the Wolverhampton Derby. Winter window will open. Alright, well, it's gonna be a busy month for sure. Let's get to the Leeds game here then. They only have 8 points. As we know, they haven't been very good. So they got Llorente starting, Mukiele starting. Sinisterra, they got Bamford up top, so no Brennan Harrison starting, no Tyler Adams starting. They've gone for Click, actually. We don't really need to get any rotation in, nobody's tired yet. We'll get some rotation in for the Brentford game, because I think that's, or should we rotate this lineup? Bishop in, let's put Dubois in for Ake there. Let's get Newton in for Ruben Sanchez. Let's put Fredrickson in for Gunnarsson. And why is Ross? Bishop up top, because I think I want to have Bishop for the Brentford game, so let's put Campbell up top. We still don't really have a striker. We, like I said, we have 3 strikers, which means we don't have a striker. 11 goals for number 11. I'm surprised that's the Premier League top scorer. Like, I'm surprised Holland doesn't have more. Chelsea has like 28 goals or something. Somebody that has more than 11. I guess because they have so many attackers. We're live from YouTube Park. A Wednesday night game. Against, I just realized too, this is, we have a rivalry with Wolverhampton. But you can also say we have a friendly rivalry with Leeds because, Jesse Marsh, we're both American head coaches. I don't think FIFA fires head coaches, so I think Marsh will always be on the team. It's not like Football Manager. Oh, here we go. Here's Campbell. So far, Shulin Lopetegui has the one up on me. That's because he played me in my second ever game. I didn't have any chemistry or anything. So we'll see how the battle with Jesse Marsh and I will get going. Here's Newton. Let's just shoot it. Did that get deflected? No, it didn't. Okay. Interesting. Newton's going with the tucked in look. So that right center back, Reyna, I guess this is his first start for us. So, we're still rotating, obviously. And it's person's quick. Where is that? Oh, that could be a card. Where's the thief? Shot from a bit too far out there. Bamford probably should wait a little bit. A yellow there. Take it. Oh, God. That's unfortunate. It's a good goal. It's, you know, they start off as the worst team, but in November they've won two games, so they went from 1 point to 7 this month. So they were last, and now they're like 17th. So they're still in relegation, but you know, they're not at the bottom anymore. All right, here's Anthony Robinson. Can we get across it? Yes, we can. Campbell, that's it. No, it's not. So close. Uh-oh. Is that Bamford that turned for Leeds? Is Joachim Check? No, Joachim Check. I mean, now look at that. That's close. Oh, it was Perkins. The guy that scored for Leeds is hurt. He's alright, he's still in the game. Oh, that actually worked. Nice job, Fredrickson. I wonder how he's feeling since he lost the job to Gunnarsson and we only really started Fredrickson like 2 times. Fifa is someone that's probably not going to be on this team by the end of January because, like I said in the previous episode, we got him for free. If somebody, it's kind of like Eriksen with Brentford, right? Like he was one of their better players. He was one of their better players, but you're never going to block a move for a player to get higher wages on a better team, and you're going to make money. You know, if I can get like 20 million for a Fifa, that's probably something I would take, and you just use that to replace. Because at the end of the day, if you were to say no, now if it's somewhere like Everton or something, then you know you don't have to. it to him because that's just how it would work. And he scores. But that's just how it would work. We have to make money to get these players in. And we would certainly not be as good as a team without a fee. But at the end of the day, we'd be able to use the money that we sell him for to buy players. And right now, FIFA is probably the only player I can think of that I would sell. All those guys on my short list, if I was to get Elise or something for a thief, that's basically, you know, I'd be happy with that. And Elise would develop. Here we go. It's a thief again. That's cool. Let's go. He's got two, and we've got the lead. He's definitely gonna probably be sold. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, from now, am I going to be starting a 78 overall? Because he's not going to develop to anything higher than a 79. He has like a year for each development point, and he's in excellent form. So if he wasn't in good form, then it would be like 2 years to get one overall. So in 2 years from now, I'm not going to be starting a 78 overall. A thief would be worth any more than he is right now. Like, if he's the Premier League top goal scorer in the winter transfer window, you know, he's not going to be worth any more any other time in his career. Get a hat trick here. It's a good save. Let's be honest, the top goal scorer would always get sold if they're on a team like this. Like Spurs would want him or something, I don't know. We're not selling the Wolves though. I'll tell you that right now. No Wolves for you. Alright, we need to get some subs in. Some final minute subs here. So we'll go with our strong lineup against Brentford. We went pretty weak today, and we're still probably going to get the win. There you go, look, Romero. That's a screamer of a goal. I haven't seen him do that. Well, we definitely have the one up. .07 XG, how about that? Alright, 3-1. Then we have three more guys coming in here for the final 10 minutes or so. Maybe 11. This is a big 3 points because, you know, it's a team that we should win against, but, you know, sometimes you get draws out of them. So, as a mid-table team, this is huge for us to pick up 3 big points against a team that we really should, but you never know. It wasn't looking good at the beginning. It was 1-0 at halftime. But we've had a great second half with the FIFA and Romero and the midfield really controlling. They might get a free kick. I said that'd be a pretty useless yellow card to have, but we're not going to accumulate. You know, I don't get too many cards. We're not going to accumulate a match ban from cards. Oh, what a safe hunter. Don't let him get that consolation card. All right, well, it was a packed house tonight. Look at this one by Shockham Check. So close. All right, how did the guys do? How did the guys do? Good game for Max Gamble. He got a couple assists. Afif got a couple of goals. Bishop got an assist. Luca got the goal. So we've got a grand total here of 20 points. We're sitting in ninth. How about Wolves, Villa, and Everton right now? We're doing good. We're up to 6 wins now. And Brentford is... Okay, Leeds are back. So we should really pick up a win here. Put together a couple of good results. And you know, we're only 4 points away from Europe right now. Sold out at the G-Tech. A nice stadium. Let's see. Brentford could be good. I think I have a Tony. Attack early. Give him a foul. Oh, wow. though he's a good player. Some sort of change in midfield. Let's get Fredrickson on. Let's get Oakley on. That's good. It's in. Okay. I knew that was a good corner and he got the perfect head on it.
Some questions regarding the match.
After getting the late goal, did you expect to do fine? I mean, I honestly did. Yeah, we just couldn't get on the end of the chances. Does the defeat today?
That'll be all. Thank you so much.